However, we all know that protocol takes precedence over procedure. This parliamentary point of order, based on the state of inertia, developing a centrifugal force which is used as a catalyst rather than a catalytic agent, which hastens a chain reaction and remains the same in a condition prior to its inception. This pivot, or focal point, which is used as a tangent in that symphony of thought, in the development of ideas, based on the ideology that the confrontation assumed proportions when we look through that horizon and find it easy to install the... rather than to accept the dullness of dreary reality so that we can ultimately give vent to our spleen so that the bile is secreted through the pancreas. This, however, where we must be cognizant of the outer areas and regions beyond our control and set upon that oasis, look to our party's platform, rest on our record and feel secure with the knowledge that salvation is its own reward. Now, many people say, what the hell is he talking about? I'm only repeating what Bush is saying. We are a great nation. Our forefathers fought and died and bled so that we can fight, die, and bleed. Well, did you come here on a bet? Because this is a music room, a room to hear this jazz. I was listening out there. Everybody plays by themselves. Why don't they just play together and end? And they say, blow it out your horn, and he did it. It is an amazing phenomenon, really. Life, I tell you, life is memories. I mean, the appositional sentence with the predicate nominative is indicating that the intransitive verb leads us to believe that life is memories. They're synonymous. Therefore, if you don't do it when you're 13, when you're 50, you got nothing to remember. I think the most important thing in life is an attitude. You have an attitude. You wear a smile on your face all day long. You walk up the street to the city of New York, you'd be surprised how many people come over to you and say, what's so funny? I saw guys on Fifth Avenue and 23rd Street. I saw men with cement, wheelbarrows, shovels. I went over to what guy? I said, what do you make? He says, the other guy says, what do you? He says, well, I'm building a hospital so that sick people can get well. That guy had a good attitude, but he lost his job. He was supposed to be building a garage. This bum walks up to this wealthy woman and says, madam, I'm broke. Can I borrow a buck? The woman looks at them. Bowman says, neither a borrower nor lender be, Shakespeare. And the bum looks up at her and says, fuck you.
It's 8 o'clock.
I think that Tennessee Williams is more quiet. Everybody, even Dick Cheney says, fuck you. No royalties. No, he doesn't mean really nothing. And here's a man that can afford it. But the thing about Bush, when he says that in Iraq they want peace, democracy, and security, and Bush says he's going to find these people and bring them to justice. Yeah.